Where to go that is not too far from Manila? There are a lot of options out there. But if distance and convenience are the top considerations, then it's hard to beat Antipolo. Hey there, poor traveler, we are Vince and Yosh. We have traveled to the Rizal capital a few times this year to find out what it's like to visit its attractions and what has changed in the new normal. In our previous video, we focused on the romantic and artistic side of Antipolo and visited Pinto Art Museum and Kaulayaw Cafe. This time around, it's all about family-friendly attractions. Before we begin, don't forget to subscribe to our channel and ring the bell to get notified when we upload new travel videos.
Babalikan natin yung Crescent Moon Cafe. Take 2 natin yon kasi yung last time na pumunta tayo doon, medyo maraming tao and walang available na table. And Saturday kasi yon lunch time. So this time, makakarating tayo doon ng past lunch na and Tuesday ngayon. So off-peak.
We start this episode with a return to the ever-elusive Crescent Moon Cafe. The last time we were here, it was full and we couldn't wait for a table, so we decided to just skip it. Ever so determined, we gave it another try because, you know, maybe fate is kinder to us this time around. And
apparently, close sila pag Tuesday. Yung ceramics lang daw yung open, pero yung restaurant ay sarado. Pero yun nga. So medyo bummer kasi second time na namin na dumayo para pumunta ng Crescent Moon. Pero talagang ayaw nilang magpatikim ng food, it seems.
That didn't work out well either. Oh well, but this hiccup shouldn't bring me down because in a bit, I'll be on Cloud 9. No really, the place is called Cloud 9.
So punta na lang tayo sa Cloud 9, which is yung dapat na second stop. Yung pupuntahan talaga natin sa Cloud 9 ay yung view, pero may restaurant sila doon, so kumain na lang tayo doon.
Cloud 9 Sports and Leisure Club, which was originally opened to the public as a restaurant in 1995. Eventually, it included lodgings and other recreation and events facilities. But the main highlight is the 360-degree view deck, which allows a panoramic view of the surrounding areas including the Metro Manila cityscape. This terrifying hanging bridge will lead you to the viewing platform. The entrance fee is 60 pesos, but if you eat at their in-house restaurant, and the total cost of your order is above 300 pesos per person, you can enter for free. You just need to present a receipt, so keep it with you. Have your body temperature checked and fill out the health declaration form upon entry. There are plenty of alcohol stations too. But wait, we're still hungry, so let's have lunch first.
Dito na tayo ngayon sa Cloud 9. They strictly implement yung mga new normal rules dito. So, bawal yung bata. 14 years and below.
Cloud 9's spacious open-air restaurant has a pretty extensive menu. Our team tried grilled liempo.
Masarap yung supa nila.
Fish Shanghai roll. Sinigang na bangus sa miso. Miki bihon and tokwat baboy. Yep, we were that hungry. It's not the romantic type and it's not particularly known for the food, but it's fine because most visitors are here for the Bridge of Terror, also known as Sky Bridge. Yeah.
Balik ka na lang.
While my cousin Pampam is still trying to regain composure, let's check out the view. After a filling meal and a terrifying walk, it's time to move on to another iconic Antipolo attraction, ang Hinulugang Taktak. Designated as a national park in 1990, the Hinulugang Taktak protected landscape covers 3 hectares of verdant forest with a waterfall as its centerpiece.
Ayan guys, I have sad news. Sarado rin yung Hinulugang Taktak.
Sadly, it was closed when we visited.
So ngayon, didiretso na tayo sa Antipolo Church, sa Antipolo Cathedral. Tapos, pupunta tayo sa Pasalubong Center para bumili ng suman at ng kasuy na primary products dito sa Antipolo.
Getting to the church's parking space can be quite the challenge, but signs abound. you'll also be greeted by these guys who have the stamina to lead you there on foot. They won't be charging for this, but their only request is to buy Pasalubong from their store. We'll get to that in a bit. First, let's check out the church. Antipolo is a pilgrimage city, thanks largely to its famous cathedral, officially named National Shrine of Our Lady of Peace and Good Voyage. The church was completed in the 17th century but has undergone several reconstructions and renovations over the years. It attracts huge crowds of devotees during Holy Week and the pilgrimage season. Don't leave without a quick stop at the Victory Pasalubong Center just next to the cathedral and grab some suman, kasuy, or cashew nuts.
Yeah. 1, 2, 3, body bar. Only 2 glasses, 500.
And other local products. We chose to buy from this store. If you need more information about traveling around the Philippines, you'll find comprehensive travel guide on our website, www.thepoortraveler.net, or check out the links in the description. If you have questions, make good use of the comment section below. You can also follow us on Instagram, TikTok, Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube. Just look for @thepoortraveler_L. You may also follow and tune in to the Poor Traveler podcast on Spotify. That's all for now, and remember, plan smart, travel safe, and make every trip worth it!